here on Headphone Trips. We're doing some of the best remakes ever done, mainly with songs. We might talk about some movie remakes.
Movie, television.
Television.
The redo, redo, redo of Hollywood.
Ice cream.
The
dogs.
New kind of dogs. New remake kind of dogs.
Yeah.
I got some early shout-outs.
Yeah, let's get some ripping shout-outs here.
Yeah. I'd like to start the shout-outs with shout-out to Jessica.
Hi, Jessica.
Better soon from the gang.
Get better soon, Jessica.
I got a shout-out to VIP Barbers on 203 West Walnut Street in Carbondale. And the cool dude, Apollo, he set my beard straight. He's got scissors that contain magic. So VIP Barbers, 203 West Walnut. Go there, come out better looking. Go in there, you're not good looking, you come out better looking.
Yeah.
And we got some shout outs later on in the show for when we know that people are going to be in their cars during drive time. But that's it for now.
Yeah. Okay. Well, first on the agenda here is...
Yeah, what do we got?
Well, you know, people have done songs over again through the years. It used to be there was a singer-songwriter was popular in the 70s, but for most of the time, usually you'd have a person who writes songs and other people who perform them. Don't you remember, it's kind of in the 70s when that changed. You had the singer-songwriter and the bands making their own music. But you had these standards, and then people did covers of them.
Sure. It harkens back to vaudevillian times when there was a song that everybody knew. And different entertainers would pass out sheet music prior to radio. And that way everybody would know the song. It was a popular song. A lot of it's public domain now, but, you know, old standards.
Exactly. Well, I think we're going to start it out. There was a song called My Way, made famous Frank Sinatra,
and
Elvis, and Sid Vicious.
Right.
Doing it the crazy way. And actually, you talked to a friend of ours about this very subject. Let's take a quick listen to that.
Frankie D here today with Matt. Matt, who do you think has the best version of My Way? It's Frank Sinatra, Elvis, or Sid Vicious?
Oh, man, probably Costello, right? Or Sinatra, right?
Elvis Presley, not Elvis Costello.
Oh, no.
Well, Matt, avid rock and roller and huge, huge fan, a music fan like myself, thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you, Frank. It's been a pleasure.
And thank you very much, Matt. He's a big fan of Pearl Jam, isn't he?
Huge fan of Pearl Jam. I defy anybody to be a bigger fan.
Yeah, he's got tattoos of Pearl Jam. Every single album Pearl Jam did, he has a tattoo, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Wow. Now that is a fan. And speaking of Pearl Jam, next week we are going to have the very best of grunge 90s rock.
I'll wear my plaid shirt.
Yeah, so we got Jane's Addiction, Stone Temple Pilots, Pearl Jam, of course. Help me out here.
Soundgarden, Soup Dragons.
Yeah.
Nirvana.
Nirvana, yeah. King's X was said to start out some of that grunge, heavy, soft kind of feel going on. So we're going to be doing that, so hang on to that. But right now, I did a mashup. This is Frank's great idea here, a mashup of My Way with Frank Sinatra, Elvis Presley, Sid Vicious, and just for crazy fun, Celine Dion. Let's take a listen.
Been dying all week to hear this.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm sure.
I've lived a life that's full will lead and every highway. I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention.
Much more than this, I did it my way.
I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing.
And now the tears have subsided.
May I say, not in a shy way, oh no, no, not me, I did it my way.
Oh, what is a friend, what has he got when he wears hats and he cannot
to say the thing.
Yes, it was my way.
Gee, and how many different ways are there to do that?
Well, I have to admit, if you do the list, do the checklist,
yeah.
Sinatra, did he do it his way? You betcha.
You
he
bet.
He did everything Sinatra's way.
Yeah, like the boss.
Elvis did everything his way. He walked into the White House with a gun and gave it to Richard Nixon.
That's not a smart thing to do.
No, he was Elvis. He could do whatever he wanted. He did it his way. Sid Vicious.
It was empty, though. It was
loaded with potential. Sid Vicious did everything his way.
Indeed.
Never backed down, did everything his way. Now we roll around to the fourth one in that mixer-upper, Celine Dion, which I think would be appropriate if she sang did it their way, referring to her managers, because the first three were rebels. They were just complete rule breakers and did whatever they wanted. But Celine is commercial. She's more commercial, and I...
Well, you're the expert. You have to tell me. I don't really know too much about her, so...
Well, she's a Canadian, and she's polite. Not that those are...
Well, she's French.
French-Canadian.
She even has a French accent. Yeah.
And she has... She's like a like an apple... candy, what, a caramel apple on a stick. Her head's way too big for her body. But, you know... She's got a pretty voice, I'll grant her that. But as far as living up to the lyrics of My Way, the first three champions blaze a trail on which nobody could really do ever again. They truly did it their way. But, you know, then you have somebody who has to follow the confines of make sure that they do the concerts right, and do the venues correctly, and don't shake it up, and yeah. don't do anything outrageous, and follow the rules.
Yeah.
And that would be...
Yeah, I would like to see Elvis do it in a rockabilly way. Because his version kind of sounds an awful lot like the Frank Sinatra version.
Yeah.
To be honest with you.
Soulful.
Yeah.
Yeah, just
yeah.
here I am, feel it.
Yeah.
And then the Sid Vicious version is just a big middle finger up in the air.
Yeah.
At the end of the video, speaking of guns, he just opens up a, you know...
The
just watch the video.
Ass,
yeah. it's a funny video. I mean, he doesn't take
Gatling
it seriously
gun.
At all.
Yeah.
He's just like, as a matter of fact, he puts his hand over his Adam's apple at one point and goes, you know, and he's rolling his eyes, singing in falsetto.
Yeah.
You know, just a whole screw this.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Which, indicative of the whole, you know, punk rock movement.
That's right, the punk rock movement there. Yeah, that's right. He did it his way. And then, of course, we have more standards. It's funny, SCTV did a little something on Stairway to Heaven. It's considered the greatest song ever, but I'm going to say I've really only heard one other version of it, which we will be coming to in just a moment.
Of Stairway to Heaven.
Stairway to Heaven. And this is how, in case, for those of you who don't know, Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin... we're just going to give you just a little clip of that. There might be some out there who don't know how that sounds. And there you have it.
This is one of the songs you wanted to hear at a school dance if you could pick somebody you really liked. Because you knew you were going to be dancing with them for a long time because it's a really long song.
It is a really long song, and then you have to, like, rock out with them.
Yeah, then it got confusing because if you didn't know how to fast dance, you were stuck, like, trying to bust a move and then go back to slow dancing.
Yeah, headbang.
Yeah.
Headbang. Push her back.
Yeah.
And headbang, and you got it made.
And then and draw them back in.
Yeah. Yeah, and then, you know, kind of get into the circle where you do the pumping into people.
Mosh pit?
Yeah, mosh pit. And then in a mosh pit, and there you go.
Just Stairway to Heaven, yeah.
That's right. So anyway, this is Stairway to Heaven. And this is what one group said about that.
It's the greatest rock song ever written, Stairway to Heaven. The one song you just can't get enough of. And now KTEL has collected 30 different versions of this beloved contemporary classic on one 12-inch stereo LP. Yes, if you love Stairway to Heaven now, you'll love it dozens of different ways with KTEL's new Stairways to Heaven. And what would heaven be without stars? And Stairways to Heaven has 30 great stars with their own interpretations of Led Zeppelin's musical milestone. You'll hear George Benson, REO Speedwagon, Stewart.
There's a lady who's sure all that glitters is gold.
Hold on to your headsets. There's more. Devo, Farami and Teicher, and Buffy St. Marie.
Your head is humming and it won't go.
And for you classical buffs, Luciano Pavarotti.
There was a lady we all know.
From the soulful baritone strut of Barry White.
Baby, 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 it makes me wonder.
To the popular country crooning of Slim Whitman.
And she's buying a stairway to heaven.
All the way to the saucy stylings of Ricky Lee Jones.
And she's buying a stairway. Buy a stairway. Go use a ton of cash.
Hey, kids, turn Mom and Dad onto the great sounds of Stairways to Heaven with the five neat guys.
And she's buying a stairway to heaven.
And get this, here's America's favorite copycat, Rich Little, singing it as only he can, sounding so close to the original, it's scary.
If there's a bustle in your bedroom, don't be alone there. It's just that sprinkly for the May Queen.
If you went to a record store to buy this record, they'd laugh at you, not because of your looks, but because they're not allowed to sell it. That's right, Stairway to Heaven is not available in stores. Available only by mail. Stairway to Heaven. 30 versions of Stairway to Heaven at 33 and a third. For a third of the price you'd pay in a store. But once again, you can't buy it in a store. Send $9.99 per record, $12.99 for 8-track paper cassette to Stairway to Heaven. P.O. Box 104, Mellonville. Send now.
All right, and that was Stairway to Heaven. That was SCTV doing a Stairway to Heaven thing. Everybody knows the version.
That is hilarious. It was Mr. Dave Thomas of SCTV. The people have called it the Canadian Saturday Night Live. I think it stands on its own as one of the greatest comedy television programs, especially when it was a Network 90 form. Dave Thomas, Rick Moranis, Eugene Levy, Catherine O'Hara, Joe Flaherty.
Yeah, great stuff. Yeah. And this is my first offering. I considered the My Way as your first offering. This is my first offering as a version that is stands on its own as a very good version of Stairway to Heaven. And this is Dread Zeppelin.
Love Dread.
Thank you. you don't know, the piper's calling you to join him. Dear lady, can you hear the wind blow? Oh, and as you know, your stairway lies on the whispering wind.
That is Dread Zeppelin with a fantastic copy.
Great.
Oh, right at the end there, Tortelvis just soars at the end. Tell us a little bit about Tortelvis and Dread Zeppelin.
Dread Zeppelin, a Led Zeppelin cover group that does reggae versions of Led Zeppelin, and their lead singer is an Elvis impersonator named Tortelvis. One time in an interview, Tortelvis was asked what his favorite food was. He said a Whopper, wrapped in bacon, slathered in butter, and deep-fried, set onto the counter, allowed to cool, double-battered, and double-deep-fried.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
That's what Elvis would like, too.
Mm-hmm.
If you're going to impersonate Elvis, you might as well go all the way.
All the way. Don't pull out any...
That's right.
Stops.
So, now, that was mine. Your next one coming up here. You actually talked to somebody about that. Let's take a little listen to that.
Mm-hmm.
I happen to be very fond of Something.
Oh, yeah, that's a good song.
That is Something by the Beatles?
Yes, something in the way she moves.
Yeah. I like the Isaac Hayes version.
Don't know it.
Yeah, it's you know, it's Isaac Hayes, baby, so it's all soulful.
Oh, yeah, I saw that on South Park.
Yeah. No, he didn't sing. Yeah, that is Isaac Hayes, but he didn't sing something for that. It was on one of his albums before he was known for the role of Chef.
No, I saw him on South Park, and he was singing it. The sky was blue that day, and the kids were out making smart remarks. That happened, Frank.
Wow. Okay. Frankie D, getting more confused by the minute at the very mindset of Matilda the Hun. Well, Matilda, it's been a pleasure getting confused by you.
Thank you very much.
And with you.
Uh-huh. I'm always kind of like that.
I'm going to go meditate now. Appreciate your time. And thanks for the Pete Seeger reference.
You're welcome.
Hello.
Goodbye.
Another Beatles song.
She's always like that. She's always like that. Yeah.
I needed to seek out lithium after that.
That's right.
Just to balance my noodle.
One of your favorite remakes is a remake of something by the Beatles.
By the Beatles. The remake is by Isaac Hayes.
Isaac Hayes.
For his role as Chef on South Park.
Hey, and making super cool, sexy, groovy songs.
And the thing of his version of something, it sounds as though they went, okay, Isaac, or maybe Isaac said to the band, let's throw everything in this one. A stew of many sounds. There's an orchestra. There's harmonicas. There's a folky kind of sound to it.
But they got Shemp screaming from the,
Shemp?
The Stooges?
From
yeah.
The Stooges?
Yeah.
Not at all, but it does have everything else in it.
A whistle,
sure.
Didgeridoo. Bagpipes?
Somebody banging a bagpipe up against a sink, yeah.
Fantastic. Well, we're going to take, for those who don't know Something by the Beatles, arguably one of the best Beatles songs ever written, we're just going to take just a little clip of that, and then we'll take a quick underwriter break, and then we'll come back to Isaac Hayes' version of Something.
Sounds groove.
Something in the way she moves attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way
This hour of programming on WDBX Carbondale is sponsored in part by your membership contributions and by Arnold's Market. Arnold's Market, 2251 South Illinois Avenue in Carbondale, features a selection of foods including choice meats, deli sandwiches, produce, natural foods, and many local products. Open 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. every day. Arnold's Market in the South Highway 51 Business District in Carbondale, 529-5191.
Thank you.
attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she woos me. She woos me.
George Harrison.